Then comes the most important concept, that is measurement of power. So you all know that there are two types of powers, that is DC power and AC power. First of all, in KSA we are going to look at DC power. So here if you use VA method, you will get, because basically for power you need voltage and current, and we also need the angle between them if it is AC power. Okay, but we don't require that in case of what, DC power, because the angle is zero there, right? So in case of VA method, the PM, that is measured power, is equal to PT, that is true power, plus IL square into RA. Okay, like where RA is the internal resistance of ammeter. Okay, then in case of ammeter voltmeter method, that is second one, AV method, PM measured will be equals to PT, that is true power, plus VL square divided by RV. Okay, that RV is nothing but internal resistance of voltmeter. Why it is internal resistance of ammeter? That means due to ammeter there is error in case of VA method, and in case of IAV method it is due to internal resistance of voltmeter. Because as I said in one lecture, error is always due to the load side connected instrument. So in case of VA, you are connecting ammeter towards the load, so the error will be IL square into RA. So in case of AV method, you are connecting voltmeter towards the load, so the error is due to voltmeter, that is nothing but VL square divided by RV. Okay, in both cases the measured power will be greater than true power, and then percentage error is going to become PM minus PT divided by PT. So remember, it is with respect to true power, that is with respect to true power into 100, because percentage, right? Then coming to the AC power measurement, okay, we will discuss this single phase AC power measurement in the next lecture. Okay, thank you.